गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन द ऑनलाइन कंप्यूटर क्लास. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज लेसन नंबर 14, ईमेल एंड सिक्योरिटी इन इंटरनेट. One of the most important mode of communication is electronic mails, that is emails. Email refers to the transmission of messages across computer networks in an electronic form. At present, variety of information can be sent through email, such as audio, video, animation, graph, and text. These types of information are collectively known as multimedia information. In comparison with the regular post mails, the email facility is faster and effective. Now we will study benefits of email. First, it is fast. Messages are delivered within few seconds. Second, it is global. That is, messages are delivered across the globe. That is, across the whole world. Third one, it is cost effective. There are many email service providers such as Gmail, Hotmail, Yahoo, etc. They provide free email services. You just need to have computer with internet facility. Next one, it is personal. That is, messages can be sent in personal email accounts. Next point, email is more productive. Email is packaged with facilities like calendar, address book, and ready-made templates for instant messaging. Next benefit is, email contents can be edited. That is, you can write messages, check spelling or grammar, and change content of the message. Another benefit of email is, it provides systematic documentation. That is, sent and received messages can be stored in computer for future use, or printouts can be taken. Next point, reaching many people at once. It is possible to send one message to multiple recipients at once. Next benefit is, it provides gateway to many web services. That is, you can sign up using your email ID on different social medias like Facebook, Twitter, and so on. Now we will study some disadvantages and limitation of email facility. First one, email requires that both sender and receiver computers must have the internet facility and email addresses. Secondly, you may receive unnecessary mail called junk mail or spam mail. A typical email address looks like sweetie@yahoo.com. An email always begins with username. A username is to be chosen by the user. Here, sweetie is the username. The username is followed by @ sign. After that, name of email service provider, also called host name, appears. In the above email address, Yahoo is the host name or service provider. After that, a $ has to be given. Then the domain name appears. Here, in this email address, I have chosen Yahoo as my mail service provider. You can choose any mail service provider such as Yahoo, Hotmail, Gmail, India Times, Rediff Mail, etc. Select your username with password to register your mail address. The process of registration is called as sign up. The sign up process needs to be carried out only once. Afterwards, when you use email, you must sign in. Now we will consider working of email. Once an email is sent from a computer, it goes to the sender's network and then to the internet. From the internet, it reaches the receiver's network and server using the facility of routers. Further, it has to pass through security features like firewall, if any. An email encountering a firewall may be tested for spam, that is unwanted mails, and virus filters before it is allowed to pass through the firewall. From receiver's network, it is sent to the receiver's computer. This whole process is so fast that the user thinks that he is directly sending the mail. Composing email. You can compose a new message as shown in this figure. Click on Show Attachment Bar to attach a file. Then click on Attachment button. It will ask about the name and location of the file to be attached. Select the appropriate file. It will be attached with your message. Then click on Send button to send the composed message. So today we learned about email facility. Next time we will learn about security feature in internet. Thank you.